Yeah, DD.MM.YYYY still back again over here with a well, it is theme hospital, but it's a little bit different. I'm doing this over on CorsixTH. It's pretty much a modernized version, pretty much an engine that uses the original theme hospital files and actually does make everything work for nowadays stuff. And yeah, everything should be working out fine. And I need to double check if it's everything over on... Yeah, okay, everything is showing up here. And yeah, I've done a few things here and there over at Customize. I am not really sure if I need the... Okay, I actually need that to work everywhere because there are some things between stuff and whatnot. As well as the intro, even though I'm not really sure if I need that. This one is something else. In theme hospital, the player would be able to use the top menu if the game was paused. That is the default setting in CorsixTH2, but by turning this on, everything is allowed while the game is paused. Ah, yeah. Okay, then. And I've also done a few things in here. Some things are still in the making, so to speak. And I still added a few things, or pretty much enabled a few things to make stuff able in here. Of course, everything over here. I don't even need that because we already have a cursor in here. No need for full screen because I would like to see stuff on my screen. Thank you very much. And yeah, that is pretty much everything. And I can just go over here. I don't need a tutorial because, yeah, I think it's very, okay, you know what? We will be turning it on either way. And I'll leave it on medium. I'm not going hard over there, even though I should be going there since I... said that I've played this in my childhood even, mostly because of the demo, and a little bit later on because of Corsix, when it was starting out. So, yeah, but since then a whole lot of time has passed since that, and I would like to go back into it. And yeah, that's why I'm not really sure if I'll make it a whole series in here. I will be seeing it how long it takes me to go through a level in here. Or even if I have everything in here. Not that I'm just going through the demo, so to speak, and I don't really have everything in here. So, yeah. I would be potentially guessing that it is everything because of that here. And yeah, over on the first level, and I need to pause immediately. Immediately over there. Hello, first your hospital needs a reception desk. Select one from the corridor equipment menu, and I just paused via pressing P. It is pretty much apparent in terms of... Where is it? Is it even anywhere around here? Not really there. I'm not really sure where... I had been going through around stuff here already, and I'm just... Ah, there, it's downstairs. So yeah, one is the slowest, which is the usual stuff, and we will be potentially going through normal once we did everything. And yeah, we'll just go in here immediately. We'll be left clicking that. We can either do it that way to add one or whatnot, so, and that to have it here. Click the right mouse button to rotate the desk and place it down in your hospital with the of the left mouse button. I would be saying having it here immediately would be something. You'll also need a receptionist to deal with your patients. The usual, and they are pretty much here. This is the first receptionist in the list. Left click to the flashing icon to view the next one. And we can also go pretty much back. Decide which receptionist has a good ability and fair wage, and then left click on the flashing icon to employ her. Staff ability is mostly how quick she is in terms of everything. I would be saying just this one should suffice. We'll be going in terms of everything else. And yeah, we'll be just picking the bestest one. To start diagnosing your patient's diseases, you must build a CP's office. That's pretty much over here, CP's office. To build a CP's office, you must first decide how big it is going to be. You can hold the left mouse button while you drag out your room to size. I will be saying, yeah. The blueprint is red because it's too small. Drag it out further to make it bigger. So yeah, I'm not really sure why it has to be have a minimum dimensions, which is 4x4. But having it like this, which would be similar, since there are also quite the amount of tiles in there, even more in a 4x4, it's still not there. Well, the blueprint is now big enough. And it release the mouse button, you will place it. Yeah, pretty much, but we can still move it by doing there. And we can also move it here, have it stretch here, have it stretch there. And yeah, we can still move it. Yeah, I did that one already, but we can make it fixed by just going here. And that size is already good enough. When the mouse around the blueprint walls... We are now going to insert our door in here. And I would like to have stuff here. He should be saying stuff with that one. Move the mouse around the blueprint walls to put the door where you want it. Okay, it wasn't that much in here. Place windows in the same way as the door. You don't need windows, but your staff are happier when they got something to look out of. Well, it's what I usually do. Windows everywhere. Wouldn't they be getting unhappier if they get invasion of privacy, so to speak? Whatever. And we have a whole bunch of stuff in here. What I usually do is something like... Yeah, it's quite not that much there, so... Oof. Right there. We can also right-click to rotate here as well. And I would be saying... Yeah, I can't get it over here because this entire area is where he will be going around, the doctor. So yeah, having it that way seems to be nicer, right? Left click the flashing icon to open your room for business, or click the X button to go back a step. We can also add some more stuff in here, which I usually do. There is no risk for machinery because what can happen? The PC exploding? Nah, I'm doing the usual stuff and a little bit... Wait, what? Actually, I can't do stuff. Usually I have stuff in here to make stuff pop a bit. Also, this is also quite something that's meh. So, yeah, I might need to rearrange stuff later on in the later levels or once I build another one of these. Because potentially I will be doing that. Maybe on the other side immediately. So yeah, that is that for that. The GP's office. This is the fundamental diagnosis room in your hospital. Your patients are sent here to find out what is wrong with them. They are then sent either to further diagnosis. I keep on mispronouncing stuff. So yeah, won't be mattering that much there, but still. They are then either sent to further diagnosis or to a room where they can be cured. Well, it depends how much the percentage is for them. So yeah. You might want to build another GP's office if this one gets too busy. That's what I said in terms of potentially building another one. The bigger the room and the more extra objects you place in it, the higher the prestige for the professor. Well, there can be professors in here as well, I would be potentially saying. This is also true for all the occupied rooms. The GP's office requires any doctor. Yeah, we already know stuff. The help box tells you all about that nice GP's office you've just built. You need a doctor to diagnose and treat the sickly folk. And for that, we are going through a whole bunch of stuff. And yeah, about this one is able to do some psychiatristic stuff. It's not what I want because I will be building something for him. So yeah, in terms of everything around here, it doesn't matter that much. But for total efficiency, stuff like this should be handled here. Having it here. Actually, place the doctor anywhere in the hospital. He'll head off to the GP's office once there's someone to diagnose. Just having this here should be that already. Okay, that's the basic mechanics of putting a hospital together. The doctors are going to need all the helps they can get to diagnose some of those patients. You can assist them by building additional diagnosis facilities such as the general diagnosis room. Once you have diagnosed some of the patients, you will need to build treatment facilities and clinics to cure them. A good one to start off is with the pharmacy. You'll also need a nurse to dispense the various drugs in the pharmacy. Last word of warning, keep a keen eye on your reputation. That is what will affect the patients from far and wide to your establishment. If you don't kill too many people and keep keep them reasonably happy, why isn't there karma there? Whatever. You shouldn't have too much trouble on this level. You're on your own now, good luck and all that. Yeah, and now we're actually getting the actual mission objective for that. That's also the reason why I was waiting for this to show up at the beginning. Welcome to your first hospital. Get the place up and running by placing a reception desk. We already did that via the tutorial. Build a GP's office and hiring a receptionist and a doctor. We also did that. Then wait for some business to come along. It is a good idea to build a psychiatry department and hire a doctor with psychiatric qualifications. That's what I just mentioned beforehand. And yeah, only those with that qualification can act out their profession in that department. No shit, Sherlock. A pharmacy and nurse are also essential for curing your patients. Watch out for rogue cases of bloody head. An inflation room will soon sort those out. You'll be looking to cure 10 people and make sure your reputation doesn't drop below 200. About that. Yeah, there are a few things in here as well as everything in here what we had done so far. But I'll be going through all those screens via the F keys. F1, we can get some loans if we're getting low on money. I'll be trying to refrain from doing that. And yeah, that is what we have done so far. Everything is going on around here, the usual. And yeah. Wait a second. Ah, yeah. I buy one and then sell one. At least it's not selling for even less. So that I should pay attention on what I am buying. Ooh, that's going to be something then. On page 3, we have every of our doctors, as well as nurses, as well as, yeah, most of the handymen in here, as well as the receptionist. And yeah, the morale, tidiness, and skills are also being listed here. Why everything is so low? Because there's nobody there, so there's literally everything on zero. And of course, we can get them their paycheck, pretty much raising their salary, or pretty much give them a little bit of a bonus. And we can then see as well as, yeah, how far they have come in. About that, we'll be potentially getting a level which goes into detail in that. I don't think I have anything that goes anywhere near there. On 4, we have, detail on how many handymen we have, how many plans, how many fire extinguishers, how many, since when does this count as that? I mean, those are machineries, so why does it count as 3? Well, some heaters, of course, the one we have added there, as well as how hot they are pretty much how warm they are making this place, and how much it will cost. The usual. On with the 6, we have a whole bunch of stuff. Yeah, most of the things in terms of stuff downstairs and whatnot. We, in terms of research, which is F6, research is currently disabled for the current level. Mostly because of stuff here and there and whatnot. Because, yeah, we can see cure 100% effectiveness. Sometimes we have stuff in here that are not that much effective. More on that once we get there. Also, we can charge the treatments and everything. That's how we get the money. And yeah. Yeah, we have been there. On to F7, which is the progress report for everything over here. Yeah, we can't check out anything over there because I don't think they had been. Yeah, they are not implemented yet. When they are being implemented, I am not really sure. As well as, I'm not even sure if we can even check out their stuff, so to speak, or not. Because I'm not really sure if that's even the case. Over here, we can see a graph where, well, we are currently starting. That's the reason why we are not seeing anything. We might need to go there once we have stuff. And we have the hospital policies. Sending people home if we don't fucking know what they are being diagnosed with. Or just, well, we know somewhat the amount, but we are not so very sure. Yeah, have a guess. Sub-procedure by just having that. Why would it go up to 200%? I'm not really sure. Maybe getting them a little bit more money out of their pockets, so to speak. Another something over here is the tiredness for the staff and everything. Yeah, the tired they are, the slower they are getting. So my thing, what I would be saying, it's somewhere around like 40%. I did it exact here. I would like to have it 50, but I can't do it there. And I can't even see in terms of stuff and everything. What is over here? Click here to get staff who aren't busy to help colleagues who require it. Actually, I would be liking to have it that way, because most of the time I do not like it when certain doctors that I've played in placed in certain rooms after they get tired and everything, that they just wander off about, and when they are being needed, they just shuffle themselves around everywhere, because there are several rooms with where doctors can go in. But for example, if a psychiatrist is going to the GP's office, some patient needs to go to the GP department, psychiatry department, but the psychiatrist is in the GP's office, what's the deal with then that there? So yeah, that is pretty much that, and that are all the screens. We're not done yet, because we are now going through, about stuff. Well, we already know about this. Receives their initial consultation and results in the GP's office. General diagnosis. A doctor uses the general diagnosis. I keep on mispronouncing stuff. A room for basic diagnosis of patients. Cheap and often very effective. And I would be potentially saying that I should be having this somewhere around here. It's actually the place where I would like to have some people on. Yeah, you know what? Since that is a 4x room, I'll have it there. Have it here so that if anything is going on, as well as a whole bunch of stuff here as well. So yeah, this one is for the patient to undress themselves, and this is for the usual stuff. So, also, we don't need that, but a little bit more. First of all, a little bit of heat and a little bit of plant. You'll need to employ a handyman to water the plants. Well, about that, we'll be getting there. General diagnosis. Patients who require further diagnosis are sent to be checked here. If a GP's office doesn't find out what is wrong with them, general diagnosis often will. From here, they will be sent back to the GP's office for analysis of the results preceded here. A general diagnosis room requires any doctor. And for that, we get another set in here. Let's have him in here. While we have that there, I would be potentially saying I'll be having most of the ones needing bigger stuff over here, or pretty much anything that can be cured immediately. I'm not really sure why that is needed at all. I'll be having it here. And another something, the usual. And have them in here as well. Yeah, that should be that. Also, what did you just say? Duh, whatever. Was still explaining stuff. But we know, and I've already said stuff about this. Psychiatry. Patients diagnosed with psychiatric illnesses must visit the psychiatry department to receive counseling. Psychiatrists can also make diagnosis, find out what type of illnesses the patients have, and if mental in origin, treat them using the trusty couch. And yeah. That's why we need such people. Well, it's not that much in here, but I'm not really sure if they can evolve themselves to be better doctors on their own, slowly but surely. It might be a yes, but I'm not really sure on that part. There is something in game that makes it pretty much where you can teach other doctors and to be quite better, and they are even needed for certain things here and there and whatnot, especially since certain levels where we only get one of each profession. And yeah, that's going to be something once we get there. We did everything in here so far. The ward? And I would be potentially saying, would that be okay? Actually, yes. Nice, okay. So yeah, because of all the beds in here, as well as how huge that room is, no other desks. I'm not really sure what will even happen if we have another one in there. But we will like to have some more beds in here. Yeah, let's just leave it here. The ward. Patients are kept here for observation by a nurse during diagnosis. They remain here prior to having an operation. I know there's a typo. Sheesh, and we have quite the nurse in here. I would be saying not really needed that much. And yeah, another something on stuff here. Have this one here. I would potentially say that we can get some, not there, upstairs, some stuff here and there. Having it here is a little bit better, I would be saying. So first of all, have it here, have that here, and yeah, we know. Pharmacy. Patients who have been diagnosed with and whose treatment is a drug must visit the pharmacy to take their medicine. As more and more drug cures are researched and become available, this room gets busier. I might want to build another pharmacy later. And it also takes a nurse. In actuality, I'm leaving that there. I could be potentially have this there. So yeah, on with this one. Yeah, we also need, we need handyman for quite the amount of things. And the usual, I had it set that once it gets anywhere around certain amounts. Just have it there then. Inflation clinic. Patients with the painful yet humorous condition of bloaty head must come to the inflation clinic, where the overlarge cranium will be popped and instantly reinflated to the correct pressure. Inflation clinic requires any doctor. It also requires ongoing maintenance by a handyman because of stuff here. Upgradable to 12. Well, we also get a whole bunch of things once we get to stuff and whatnot. Yeah, you know what? I will be having something for them in here. And in terms of TV, it's something else. It's just extra stuff. So yeah, staff room. Your staff gets get tired as they carry out their jobs. The usual. Who doesn't get tired? They require this room to relax and refresh themselves. Tired staff slow down, demand more money, and will eventually quit. They also make more mistakes. Building a staff room with plenty for them to do is very worthwhile. Make sure there's room for several staff members at once. Well, I would like to have built two of them. One over here for pretty much this department, and another one for, I would be saying over there. Yeah, I would be saying somewhere over here. And yeah, you know what, I will be doing those this as well. I might be saying this here. Yeah, I'll be having it there. Yeah, they don't get anything in here. I think I can build a few more in here. Actually, that should be it already. Don't need any of the toilets anymore. Actually, the radiator will be here. And here. Blade will be here. Pause for a second, I just remembered something. Okay, toilet should be gone, thanks. And I would like to replace you Yeah, toilet. Patients feel a call of nature. Fuck's sake. Patients feeding a call of nature will need to unburden themselves in the comfort of the toilet facilities. You can build extra stalls and wash basins if you expect a lot of visitors. In some cases, you might consider building further facilities elsewhere in a hospital. Well, yeah, about that. I don't think if we're even able to get any in here. Because, yeah, we only have this area in here. Also, why is that much over here? So, yeah. In terms of stuff, we have the usual stuff. And maybe a little bit more I can do over here. Do I have it there? Yeah, I have it there. All of the windows. That's mostly the reason why I have so many in here. Some more pool tables, some more sofas. So yeah, I would be saying just two of them already. There I would be saying this. Radiator, this one is already enough. Another sofa for over there. And that's that already. So they now have two of them. In terms of rooms, I am still not done yet. I did that one already, I did that one already. I did that, I did that. I did that, I did that. I think I now actually did everything. So yeah, we are done with those, but we are still not done yet. We still need a whole bunch of benches. And I think 20 are enough for now. Having them all here and there should be enough for them. So yeah, yeah, that should be surely enough. But another something, because yeah, they will be potentially also needing a whole bunch of that, some of those, a few plants as well, potentially 10. Some places to drink. How about right here at the beginning? Potentially here as well, if anybody gets over here. And I think that's already dead. One over here while we are there. One injury behind the window. That's going to be something, alright. It's already something over there, so radiator. Where would be one applicable? I would be saying the one directly in front of the drinks. Then one in here over with the lady. If I remember correctly, there would be not really. Actually, I can put one here. One over there. And one over there, because if I remember correctly, I have put something over there. And that should be that. And it would be saying Some over in here. Yeah, like a little bit there. Make it there. So yeah, we don't need much of the radiators. Maybe a little bit over here. And put everything already, so yeah, not really needed. And had been complained enough already. So yeah, more in sweeping litter. Another one for all the plants. And another one for all the machinery. There we go, that should be everything. Was I actually... I should be having everything in the clear, so we can now actually start and go to normal speed. There we go, we are now actually starting after almost 40 minutes. So yeah, that's mostly the reason why I stopped, so that I can start off immediately, because it will take a while until the first patients are even there. And I don't really need those. Yeah, also something, I'm not really sure why I'm saying this now. Yeah, there has been nothing over in here because we did not even get much. Maybe we'll be having it on 5, and there we have some stuff. We are checking them out. And one is going over immediately. Just before it goes to the next month, because once we are getting there, pause again. Yeah, we had used all of them beforehand already, and everything is getting... Jeez, we were even getting some better ones over here as well. Yeah, diagnosis process. We will be seeing stuff. And then over there, geez, two things happen at once. Well, one goes to the GP's office and one actually goes to the psychiatrist. Pause for a second. The icon that has just popped up did something apparently. Your team has discovered a new condition. It is the squids. Okay. Cause eating pizza found under the cooker. Why are you even checking, getting stuff over there? Symptoms? Surely you can guess. Pure, gluttonous mix of stingy pharmaceutical chemicals solidified the patient's innards. Okay. Meanwhile, yeah. Also, I have never done, never seen him doing anything with the skeleton. Well, over to the GP's office, and here we have the one that has the squids. Also, another something over here. Well, and we have our first one healed over here. That is great so far. Yeah, when patients have this, we can actually send them immediately to get their cure. But why do it that way if you can get about 100 extra dollars from them this way? And we also saw that now happening. Ah yeah, we can see stuff here as well, because I was talking because of other things. And another something. Also, since you're there already, okay, he's the one that does stuff here. Yeah, they can get their stress really low immediately by just, yeah, playing a little bit of billiard, and then they are out already. Do we have anything else in here? It was their first announcement. This is also another something that is quite something. The announcer. Well, what she's coming up with. Also, a whole bunch of nothing going on around here, apparently. And more plants watering. Also, yeah, about time the next one is coming in here. It's on the way to the reception desk, the usual. Actually, while we're having that there, usual over here.
Most required in pharmacy.
Okay, we have the first announcement that someone is actually literally just going over there. So yeah, she should be going over immediately. Also, we have another something. We have now found heaped piles. Goss is standing around by water coolers. Okay. Symptoms. Patient feels like she is sitting on a bag of marbles. Cure. A pleasant yet powerful acidic drink dissolves the piles from the inside. Okay then. Yeah, she is pretty much going over immediately. Heading for pharmacy, even says that. And he is going immediately over there as well. Heading for general diagnosis? Is there someone waiting over there? Doesn't seem like it. Actually, someone's incoming over there. Over checking. Two patients cured. Well, I would be saying he is going over. Is someone getting over there immediately? Okay, You get over here then. Sheesh. Okay, I'll be switching you two then. And yeah, it is apparent what condition he has.
Doctor required an inflator room.
Wait, there's nobody there? Are you... Sheesh. Well, it's of course bloaty head. Sniffing cheese and drinking unpurified rainwater. That's what causes it? Okay. Symptoms very uncomfortable for the sufferer. That's no symptoms. That's already whatever. Cure. Swollen head is popped, then reinflated in to the correct PCI using a clever machine. Well, we'll be seeing that. He's going over there immediately, so... He has to wait a little bit only. Well,
doctor required a general diagnosis.
And let me guess, he's going over there immediately, or is someone going over there already? Wait a second, where is the one? Hello? Did I have not enough? Okay, you know what? Apparently I didn't even have enough because I think I haven't placed anyone in here. That's the reason. So now stuff is going a whole bunch over here. Actually, yeah, she should be getting ready over here. Also, we can see how many people are waiting to be treated in here. Well, whatever. Another something. Uncommon cold. Well, there's the common cold, but what's the uncommon cold? Cause small particles of snot in the air. Okay. Symptoms? Runny nose, sneezing, and discolored lungs. How do you even see that from the outside? Here, a big swig of uncommon cold medicine made from special ingredients in the pharmacy will cure this. Well, someone is going to be going over there immediately. And of course it will take a while until that's there. Also, we can pretty much see that I haven't done anything at all and the money is slowly actually decreasing. If I remember correctly, we saw something over here with a light bulb over here. That is the indicator potentially that, oh. That stuff is getting better, so to speak. Also, I forgot. Oh. Sir Reginald Crumbly has expressed a wish to visit your hospital. It's your official invitation to the VIP. From the VIP off with excuses. Well, just come in. There's nothing in here. The only thing that would be potentially a little bit off is, yeah, everything over here. But in terms of stuff, Oh yeah, we are getting somewhere. Wait a second, what? I saw something beforehand. I think it was before the month rolled over. Ah, he needs to go over there as well. Maybe I should be having one over here as well, potentially. I'm not sure. Oh yeah, he's going off. And yeah. Ah, we are seeing him. Sir Reginald Crumbly. Well, he'll just be looking around. He will go from door to door and just stand in front of it looking in. And he will do this on every door. Well, it depends on stuff and everything around here, because we already have stuff over here. Well, nothing has changed over here, but should not be less than 300. The mission says something about 200. Also pause, because we now have TV personalities. Cause daytime television. Symptoms, delusions of being able to present a cookery show? What? Here, a trained psychiatrist must convince the patient to sell their TV and buy a radio. We know already has just arrived to tour your hospital, and of course it deactivated immediately. I'm not really sure how I can make him say the same thing because literally. You need to look after your plants, they are getting thirsty. It's not that much, come on. People are complaining about being thirsty. You should place more drink machines. Okay, if that's the case, I sh- Okay, you know what? I'll be placing one here, one here, one here. You are now unable to complain about stuff because I have it at most places. Additionally, I would be saying here as well. Maybe we should be having it here. Maybe I should be... Yeah. The radiator there. Another head is being popped over here. And another one is incoming. I think with that the level will be done.
Doctor required in GP's office.
Wait. Ah, oh, someone's coming out immediately? Okay, if you want to get over here immediately, just do that, jeez. Also, yeah, sofa just lower stuff, barely, I would be saying. But here... In the ward?
Nurse required in pharmacy.
Jeez, nurse required everywhere. Well... So yeah, I'm not really sure on stuff because there are 2 points in the game where stuff will be paused and checked for the win requirements. I think I passed that one already. It's usually between the 6th and the 7th month. We're already in the 7th, so that's already past that. Or are there more stops, so to speak, where it could happen? Pretty much at the end of each month. Because usually it's mostly just at every half point. What are you doing over here? Ah, going to take a drink. $20 for that? Okay. Used once. Zero times zero, 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 once. People keep on complaining that they are being thirsty. They haven't taken anything over there. Are they just not in reach or something? Is that the problem? So yeah, in terms of stuff, everything keeps on going. So yeah, if we remember correctly, they were somewhere at the middle beforehand. They actually increased in terms of speed and everything, so quite something. Also, one going over to the pharmacy, the usual. In terms of reputation, it's just okay. Yeah. There's also a bunch of stuff. What? They're visiting your hospital, so Reginald grumpily remarked. Oh dear, not a nice place to go if you're feeling, peaky. What does that mean? Very not sure what that means at all. Because all seat requirements are there, pretty much everywhere.
Not required in general diagnosis.
He's already going over there, so... So yeah, in terms of everything over here... Yeah, just wandering around. And I think just wandering around does not do anything. I'm not really sure if I actually said this one already, but... Yeah, I fiddled around with my audio settings on the mic. It's now a little bit louder even, apparently. Not really sure if it's too loud or not. I just noticed something else as well. It has happened again there. But there's nothing else to do here because... yeah. One over at the psychiatrist, and is he actually going to get his head aired out? Also, we have an invisible guy incoming. I think he's the first. So yeah, diagnosed with invisibility, going to the pharmacy, and there's somewhat a special, not really special, but because of him being invisible, sheesh, there's going to be some more stuff happening because of course. Not sure if I even... if it happened beforehand already. Pretty much. It has been used 4 times. Yeah, the maximum is 12. If it goes anywhere towards the maximum amount... Well, handyman. Wait a second, I'm only just seeing one. He is the one over there. God damn it. Is that the reason why stuff is over here? Yeah, of course he's going over there. Immediately! So we can't even see that. Well, dear Doug Barmet, congratulations. We at the Ministry are very impressed by your hospital running abilities. You are certainly a golden boy in the health department. We think you'd prefer a slightly tougher job though. You'd be paid a salary of $11,240, but the decision is up to you. Are you interested in working at Sleepy Hollow Hospital? Move on to the next level, continue playing a while longer. Not really sure if there is anything in actually continuing on with there. Potentially? Oh yeah, I did a whole bunch of stuff over here, so just have it on the stream here, and just let's move on over here.